Normally, robots are about efficiency. The question is always, how can a robot perform a task faster, better, or with greater precision? They are strictly form follows function. But we asked ourselves a different question. Can robots also be beautiful?
We're Denis and Florian, and together we work as Loomaland in Berlin.
And we created CYGNUS, which is a flock of robotic swans coming together to perform a synchronized water ballet. It's this peculiar blend of nature, technology, and art. I'd say the most interesting reactions come when people don't expect anything at all. When you arrive at a lake and suddenly you see glowing swans
and they're moving together in sync. There's something very dreamlike about it. But it was a long journey from the idea to that dream becoming real.
What's funny is that we're not engineers at all. When we first had the idea, Denis just dove into the building process. Everything is self-tested and self-built. You know, the tools are out there, so it's a little bit like go out and play, do your crazy thing if you really have to. Blue Robotics was pretty much a part of our Swan project right from the beginning. We just found their thrusters to be extremely reliable and robust. Their stuff is made for marine science and exploration, but we ended up using their technology for something quite different. Something that maybe hasn't been done before? Now, under the surface, the swans are autonomous boats. They're equipped with thrusters, servos, LEDs, drone controllers, GPS, RTK, you know, all of that. But when you actually see them moving, especially when they're turning their heads and they look at you, they become something else. They become animals.
We even had people try to feed them. They really seem alive.
Throughout history, people have always been fascinated by the idea of artificial life. Already in ancient Greece, the philosopher Archytas had created an artificial flying pigeon propelled by steam. Then, in the 18th century, you have the French inventor Jacques de Vaucanson, who famously built a mechanical duck. Already pretty close to what we're doing 200 years later. Our own story of robotic birds started as a crazy idea on a cold night, watching some swans at a lake in Switzerland. And somehow now it has grown into this installation that travels the world.
There was always one festival we kind of dreamed of. Vivid Sydney. It's one of the biggest cultural events in the world. So we had to apply. And got accepted.
Which was incredible, but it also meant the swans would have to face the sea. It meant waves, salt water, strong winds, floating debris, algae, all sorts of challenges. We were kind of scared. But we couldn't really say no to Sydney. So we prepared the swans as best as we could and got ready to literally let them jump into the cold water. When that big night came, the opening night of Vivid Sydney, we were super excited and kind of proud that this was actually happening. The swans and us had made it to the other side of the world, and now they were doing their dance in Sydney Harbour. That was one of those moments where you just think, yeah, this is it.
And like in a booth almost.
One of the highlights, unexpectedly, because we've seen so many other pieces, and then we're like, oh my god!
I've never seen these vivid attractions on the water.
They're lovely, very surreal.
It's so cool. Yeah.
It's peaceful.
It's magical. It's watching them.
Hypnotic.
Yes.
But how did they turn their heads?
The moving heads are sweet, although they did freak my friend out quite a lot.
It's very natural, the way they move.
I was expecting them sort of just to stay in one place, and then all of a sudden I've seen them moving synchronously and doing like a little dance, sort of like, I don't know, a traditional religious dance of the birds, which I find truly beautiful.
I was wondering how it works. It's something that I've never seen before, to be honest.
How did you get them to move?
I was wondering if it was by wires under the water.
But then the cords would get tangled, so I wasn't sure.
Individual people controlling each swan.
Something magnetic, I don't know.
But then it was explained to me that it was basically like water drones.
But if it's just individual autonomous drones, then too much work involved in that, I guess. Batteries and them being recognizing each other and going in motion. I thought it would be too much engineering for artwork, to be honest. Yeah.
And they were running for 3 weeks at the festival. They didn't let us down. It was amazing. We celebrated with our birds and the local ones, of course. And now? We already worked on new ideas. So the story is not over. This is just the beginning.